HTML5 sectioning elements are tags that divide the entire document into sections, and they are semantic because they provide extra information about those blocks. They act like paragraph and div tags rather than span tags or other inline tags because they put an actual space in between, like paragraphs do. So you have a space in between each paragraph. And the same is true of HTML5 sectioning elements. So here's a document that doesn't have any sectioning elements in it. It just has a lot of text. And I'm going to add a few. The first one, and the one that most people use, is the article tag. Articles are considered the main portion of the page. They are the article on the page. It doesn't have to be a text article. It can be photographs. It can be advertisements even. If that is the main focus of the page, that's the article. So when you think article, you shouldn't be thinking newspaper article. You should be thinking, what is the focus of this page? And if that's the focus of the page, that section is the focus of the page, then that's what you should surround with the article tag. Another sectioning element is the section tag. The section tag is pretty much exactly what you would think. You can give any part of your page be in a section. I am actually going to enclose my article in a section. You don't have to have more than one section. You can have just one on the site. The only thing you should remember is if the only reason you're adding this section tag is because you need to have a hook for CSS, like you want everything inside this section tag to have a light gray background color, whether it's in the article or not, and that's the only reason you have the section tag, then you shouldn't use the section tag. There's another tag for that that's not semantic, and it's called the div tag, and I'm just going to write it here. Div, D-I-V, and it means division, so it's similar to section, it's a division of the page, but it's not semantics. The div tag is just used to give your CSS hooks. And by hooks, I mean something to grab onto, something to select in the HTML. The next sectioning element that I use a lot is the aside tag. You should use the aside tag when you're talking about content that it's important for the page, because why else would you have it on the page, but it's not the primary focus of the page. So most of the time, like on a blog, you might have a sidebar in the aside. You might have advertising in the aside. You might have a search box in the aside. All of these things are things you want on the page, but they're not things that need to be on the page. The last sectioning element I'm going to talk about in this video is the nav element. The nav element, N-A-V, is the navigation, and usually it's filled with a list of links. So we might have Ahref, and then home. About. Contact. And then we close our nav tag, and we have our navigation. And this tells everybody, the browser, anybody who views the source, that this UL, this list of links, is navigation links. It's not just a list of links. It has that semantic value of navigation. Now, before you ask, the one thing that these don't do is they don't provide any look and feel. They don't change the way they're displayed. This list still has bullets. It's not horizontal across the page. You might be thinking, well, what's the good of it? But the good of it is that then I can go into my style sheet and I can say nav UL, meaning any UL that's found inside the nav, give it a list style type of none. And I can differentiate that by taking the same list and taking it outside of the nav. When I preview it, my navigation list has no bullets and my non-navigation list has bullets. That's the most common way that people use the sectioning elements, but like I said, they also serve the purpose of telling the browser, telling the user agent what this content is for. This is useful for accessibility. So people use the sectioning elements for user agents like screen readers that read the page. And if the screen reader knows that this is navigation, it might read it differently. It might provide more information to the customer so that they know that this is the navigation. The screen reader might put a bookmark itself on this area of the page so that it knows that the navigation is important. So that's why you use the new HTML5 sectioning elements, and they give you a lot more flexibility. Previously, all we had were div, and so what you will see is the div tag with maybe a class of article. You might see where the A side would be. They might say the same thing, div, class, A side. You're saying this is an aside, this is an article. You can just use an actual tag to do that now. You're not stuck with just using div tags. So those are the HTML5 sectioning elements that add semantic information to your web pages.